My name is Rachel. Today, oh, you know what? I don't have to do this on my phone. I can do this on my computer because it's right in front of me. Today, we're going to talk about everything that I read in the month of March of 2021. Can you believe that we're already done with March? This is April. This is April of 2021. What? April. There are two books that I did, one book that I did start in March that I'm not going to be able to finish, obviously, because it's April 2nd. What am I saying? It was just one book, Women, Men, and the Whole Damn Thing. I'm listening to the audiobook because I got it on NetGalley. It's a book that was published a while back. It's a dude talking about feminism. That's really all you need to know. That sounds a lot worse than I meant it to sound. It's just, it's okay. It's fine. It's fine. First thing I read was Firekeeper's Daughter by Anjali Boulay. Oh my god. So good. And it is about Donis, and she is the daughter of a Ojibwe man and a white woman, and their relationship was kind of a scandal. And so she deals with being biracial and feeling like pulled between two different worlds, right? She's a former hockey player. She's just finished high school. She's considering college. She's going through a lot of family stuff. And then she witnesses a murder, and she has been asked by the FBI to be sort of like an informant and help them with their investigation. And she decides to kind of take up her own investigation by using what she knows about like tribal medicine and speaking to her tribal elders. And it's just, it's a really complex and excellent book. And I just can't highly recommend it enough. Like, it's incredibly well written, incredibly emotional. So good. But big trigger warning for talking about drugs, specifically meth. So there is sort of on-page drug use, sort of, by one character. So just careful, trigger warning for that. And it's very emotional, so go into it when you're in the right space. But it is also really funny. There's like really good parts. I did a video actually where I talked about three thrillers that I read, so you can get more of my thoughts there. But this was definitely my favorite out of the three that I read this month, and I gave it 5 stars. Absolutely. I highly recommend. I can't recommend it enough. It is like equal parts contemporary and crime thriller, so, but I'd say it's probably more of the contemporary in the beginning and then the crime thriller towards the end. So do with that info what you will. Next thing I read was Winter Song by S.J. Jones. Thanks, RC. this was for RC's book club. Finished that series book club. And it was really bad. It's about a girl named, what's her name? Liesl? Is that her name? Her sister gets kidnapped by the Goblin King, and then she's like, oh no, I'll save you, and goes to the Goblin Realm. And it's like nonsense. It's just, she like marries the Goblin King and she's super into music, and it's just nonsense. It's just a whole book of nonsense. It was bad. It was real bad. 2 stars. I don't want to talk about it anymore. It's bad. It's a bad book. And then we didn't read the second one. We ended up switching to a different book because we did not finish that series. It was garbage. Next thing I read was a buddy read with my friend Bibella from the channel Bibella. And it was We Hunt the Flame by Hafsa Faizal. This was my second time reading it, and I actually liked it more than the first time, which I enjoyed it the last time. I bumped up my rating from 3.75 to 4. This is about a girl named Zafira and a guy named Nasir, and they live in this land that is now without magic. Nasir is the son of the, he's like a prince. And he's also an assassin, sent out by his father to, you know, K-word people. And they both, along with a few others, get pulled into this journey where they have to go to this land and retrieve this artifact to bring magic back to the world, sort of. That's kind of the plot. It's really a lot more complex than that. And it's really fun. It's a good time, and it's got some great characters. I like it. It's a really enjoyable fantasy, and it's getting adapted, which is awesome. So yeah, I recommend reading it. I am going to read the sequel. That's why I read the first one, but I still haven't gotten to the freaking sequel. It does contain shadow magic, which is, it's kind of light on that. It's only towards the end, which is my favorite kind of magic. So if you also like shadow magic, this might be a good series for you. Next thing I read was, this was my other thriller. This was the second thriller I read. Next thing I read was Our Last Echoes by Kate Alice Marshall. This is also the author of Rules for Vanishing. And this was like a 2.5 for me. This is about a girl named Sophia. Sophie or Sophia? Sophia. I always forget. her earliest memory is of being drowned, which doesn't make sense because she grew up in foster care. And then she gets like a weird message saying, come to this island where there's a bird sanctuary institute. And she finds out more about her mom and what happened to her. And it's weird. It's just an amalgamation of stuff I've already seen. So Mirrors, The Fog, Jeepers Creepers, and The Birds by Alfred Hitchcock. And there you go. That's it. That's what this book is. It was fine. I only liked one character, and it was a side character, and I think she's getting her own book. And I'm interested to read that, but this was kind of a miss for me. So I'm going to actually donate this to my little free library. Oh, the next thing I read, though, was another thriller, the third, and it was awesome. It's called House of Hollow by, what is her name? Crystal Sutherland. And this is about three girls, they're sisters, and when they were kids, they went missing for a month, and then they came back, and they came back weird. And their dad committed suicide, and their mom raised them, but they're all kind of odd. And our main character is Iris, the youngest, and her sisters, Libby and Gray, are living out of the house, and then they're supposed to meet up one night, and then Gray is missing. So Livy and Iris go and they try to find her, and then they find out more about what happened to them. And I liked a lot about this. I just wish that the synopsis had been written differently, because it kind of gives away what I think is too important of a piece of information that I wish I had found out slowly throughout the book. However, I really liked that this was like self-aware and that it knew how creepy it was, and it like commented on that, because there's like some creepy shit. There's like rivers of dead people and ants crawling out of like pustules in skin and creepy death flowers that only grow around corpses, and a guy running around in a bull skull with runes written in blood on his chest chasing them. It's got a lot of creepy stuff. But I liked it. There were like two mysteries, the smaller one and the big one, and I figured them out a little bit beforehand, and I kind of wish that she had thrown me for a loop and I hadn't figured them out, but I really enjoyed it. I thought that the characters were really fun to follow. I like the whole like Scooby-Doo vibe that it gave, of like this like gang of young people solving a mystery and like cracking some jokes along the way. But also it was really dark. So I highly recommend it if you like thrillers. I gave it 4 stars. I will say though that this is like a supernatural sort of thriller, and it's got some like body horror elements, so if you don't like that, don't read it. Next thing I read was A Reaper at the Gates by Hafsa Faisal. I was working on this series for the last 2 months, and I read Sky Beyond the Storm, so Reaper was a reread. Reaper and Sky both got 5 stars. I ugly cried during Sky Beyond the Storm. There was a particular character death that I just did not want that to happen, and it did, and I'm just really hurt. And I just want to know why Saba Tahir wanted to do me so dirty. I am in pain and I don't like it. So I think that now that it's concluded, I think that has replaced Fury Born as my favorite series. So it's all of the Ember Quartet, and then Fury Born, I would say, is my favorite, with Six of Crows like somewhere in between. Because, oh man, that the way that she writes Hafsa Faisal, what? Saba Tahir, Rachel, go to bed, is so intricate and so smart. It's like a masterful weaving of plot that clearly she had like thought through from the beginning. It all came full circle. It was so perfectly done, and I just was blown away. My camera's dying. So the next thing I read was A Gentle Tyranny by Jess Corbon, aka Jesse Manassian. I did a full video explaining who Jessie Manassian is. She's a homophobe, and she used a pseudonym, she admitted, in order to distance herself from her other work so that she could tell convey deep truths about gender, like men are being emasculated, to a YA audience via her new dystopian book, which comes out April 7th or so. April 7th. Oh boy. Okay. If you want to be evangelized to, feel free to read it. I did an entire review. I will link that down below. Please go watch it. All the revenue from those videos that I did on her, there's two videos, will be donated to help queer BIPOC youth, because that is a harmful woman, and I cannot believe that she used subterfuge to try to market a book about gender truths to a group of readers that has a lot of queer young people in it, that a lot of them already deal with religious trauma. So that was gross, and I'm mad about it. And she should this could have all been avoided if she just would have labeled her shit Christian fiction and not done subterfuge. I would have left her alone. I don't read Christian fiction. Don't try to lie about your book. Don't try to lie just because you're a Christian and you want to evangelize. Just say that up front. Links down below. Next thing I read was The Mothers by Britt Bennett. And again, if you did not already, check out Sangra, because they made beautiful bookmarks and book sleeves to match. This was a beautiful book. This is about a young girl who, she gets pregnant not long after her mom has committed suicide. And then it's just like the long-term effects of what happened because of her mom's suicide and her choosing to get an abortion. And I feel like it was just a really well done book, and it shows like what that did to like different relationships in her, and what that did, what all that, like how that was spoken about in her community, and how that affected her relationships with the dude who got her pregnant, and her best friend. So it was just a really beautiful book, and I can't recommend it enough. Britt Bennett's writing is exquisite and moving, and oh, it hurt me a little bit. I also think that this is a really good book to have a nuanced discussion about, like pro-life, anti-choice people like to throw in your face. What about people who regret their abortion? And I think that people who have abortions, they sometimes, most of them do not regret it according to one survey, but I think that people go through different points in their lives where they have regret and then they don't have regret, they have regret, they don't have regret. I think that a lot of people go through that, and we should talk about that and normalize it. And I think that this book is a great jumping off point to have that discussion, because that's normal. It's similar to how like I had two miscarriages, and if I had not had the miscarriages, then I wouldn't have my youngest son today. So there's like a bittersweet, I go back and forth on how I feel about them, and it's more complex than just like a black or white issue. So, all right, what's next? Next thing I read was The Winter Duke by Clara Eliza Bartlett, and this was RC's. Instead of reading Shadow Song, we're gonna read this. And this was like a YA, sort of like a mystery thriller set in a fantasy setting that was very political. And if you like politics and sapphic romances, I can't recommend this to you enough. I loved the love interest in this. She was such a bad bitch. She at one point told the main character, if you're gonna be a coward and run away, I'm not gonna follow you. I don't follow cowards. And I was in love with her at that point. So if you like sapphic romances and politics, read it. You'll like it. It's got a little bit of like Cruel Prince dark fae vibes, sort of. So if you like that, check it out. Next thing I read was this enormous book. Me and Cindy Buddy read this. I don't know how to rate this. Winter Duke, I gave 4 stars. 3.75. I don't know what to say. I'm gonna do a review, so I'll just say that. I love Nesta, so this was in parts fun for me, and then in other parts, Sarah J. Maas's writing I have some trouble with, so I don't know. Do with that what you will. God, that book is huge. And the last thing I read, Okay, I have some trouble saying her last name because it's got a lot of I's in it. So it was Ace of Spades by Farida Abike Iyemide. I think that's how you say it. And this threw me for a loop. I went in and for a big chunk of the book, I'm thinking like, this is a Pretty Little Liar situation where there's like a person or a couple people who are doing these things and it's like bullying. It's not that. It's more of a like, I don't want to spoil it. Kind of like a Manchurian Candidate thing going on, if that helps you. If you read When No One Is Watching and you enjoyed your reading experience, then I would read this as well. That's what I'll say. I loved it, not just for the mystery thriller element, but also, man, that cat is driving me nuts.
Man.
But also, Devon, one of the main characters, my heart broke for him, and like, I feel like he's out there somewhere and I want to like check in with him. Like, I want to make sure that he's okay because I am genuinely worried for him. Even though you get to know like a future, like where they're at, I just was so concerned for him. He just broke my heart so many times. And every time like he actually said like, I'm heartbroken because of what people have done to me. Oh, I felt every single part that he talked. I don't know what it was, but I felt like really like worried for him at all times. I'm not crying right now. This is ridiculous. I cried a few times reading his part, just like, you know, tearing up a little bit because it was so heartbreaking how much pain and loss he had to go through. And he just wanted somebody to like be there for him and people kept bailing. And I just felt like his loneliness. So it was just so tangible. So, okay, that's enough. That's enough, Rachel. So 5 stars because that book was fantastic. I can't recommend it enough. Huge thank you to NetGalley and the publisher for giving me that because, oh my gosh, NetGalley really came through for me this month with the thrillers. Just wow. All right, that's everything I read. Let me know your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to donate, you can to my coffee down below. Like, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye.